Hello YouTube makeup lovers, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to Be Lounge Makeup, I really hope that you guys stick around and subscribe for more videos. So I'm here today with a lot of information and a lot of goodies to share with you guys for the Sephora sale that is going on right now. The sale actually started yesterday, which was November 5th, and I'm really hoping that I can get this video up sometime this weekend because I do want to share with you guys all the goodies that I did buy. This was the first time that I actually went to the store on the first day. So I went yesterday to Sephora and I got a lot of good things that I wanna share with you guys, just to give you guys some ideas and some of my recommendations. And I also got a few things online as well, which those I bought right away because they were the things that I kinda thought would sell out the quickest. Right now, if you are Rouge, you get the 20% off from November 5th through the 15th. If you are VIB, you get 15% off from the 9th to the 15th. And if you are an insider, you get 10% off from the 11th to the 15th. So I really wanted to post this video to give you guys ample time to shop just with these recommendations. As always, I will list everything that I mentioned in the description box down below. And the products that I don't have here, I also will show you on my iPad, which are the ones that I kind of recommend, and kind of share with you guys some of the things that I bought online, which I should be getting them. The shipping has changed a little bit. It takes a little bit longer than usual. I should be getting them next week on Thursday, according to like the ship date. But I did take advantage of the sale. I feel like out of the two sales that Sephora has on a yearly basis, because they have one in the spring around April, and then this one, which usually starts in November, the one in November I love because they have so many beautiful gift sets for the holidays, and you can really take advantage of really great deals in those sets. And in addition to the gift set deal already, you also get the additional percentage off that goes with the tier that you are with Sephora. So we better get started because I have a lot of products to share with you guys. So this year I saw something new that I hadn't seen before, and I got one for myself, and then I also got one for my mom for Christmas because I think that she'll really love it. They have these beautiful sampler sets. This is actually the Sephora Favorites Deluxe Perfume Sampler, and it has all these pretty big generous size samples. It has six. This is $75 plus the 20% off, but inside it comes with a gift certificate that it has a barcode, and you can basically go back to the store, select from these perfumes, pick the one that you like the most, and you get a full size at no extra cost. So that's really the first time that I have seen that way. Honestly, we already like, you know, I was at the store and I was like, I'm just gonna do it already right now. And I opened it, it had a nice little gift card up here. And then I picked one out for my mom and already got the full size at no extra charge. So it really is a really great deal. I mean, the perfume, the full size on its own was about $75 already, or around that amount. So you really do get a really nice deal, and I think it's really worth the price. And then you can also try all of these other perfumes. I don't know if you can see it well. This is the candle sampler, and you see you get all these candles, and then that's a little photo of the gift card. This is called Mini Candle Discovery Set, and I always like to read in these sets. It's the price is $50, but it says in parentheses it's an $80 value. I love those with those Sephora favorites just because you kind of get to see if you really are getting a good deal. And this had really nice candles. It had candles from Otherland, from Replica, from Ness, from Voluspa, from Maison Louis Marie. And then you go back and you get a full size of those candles. So I thought that was a really, really good deal. And at the store, I did not see it at the Sephora store yesterday, so I got it online. And right now I'm looking at this online here, and now it says it's only available in stores. So sometimes it is good to do both, because sometimes what you can get in store, you can't get online, and vice versa. I got a really nice cologne for my dad. I always take advantage of this sale to get colognes for my dad because he loves wearing cologne. And this is the Y by Yves Saint Laurent. This is what it looks like. It's just a really nice, beautiful, you know, cologne. It smells so good. I love the way it smells. So it's something new that he hasn't tried, and this is again a great sale to buy the more expensive type of items. Another great set that I got is from Laneige. This is $18, and it had five little type of samples from the lip sleeping mask. And there's some of these that I haven't tried. I absolutely love the mint green one. I think it's, that one's a choco mint. And then of course the regular one, but I hadn't really tried the yellow one, and I haven't tried the more pinky one. This one right here, this one right here is the original, but I thought that this was really cute. This I was able to find in store. When I tried to get it online, it was sold out. So that one I was able to get yesterday. And also by the brand Olaplex, they had this really great set that has the number 3 hair perfector. It has the bond maintenance shampoo, the bond maintenance conditioner, and it also has the small bonding oil. So I thought this was a really great set to try more of the Olaplex products. I was very strong not to buy it. The number 3 usually comes this small. They had the deluxe size for a really great deal. I almost wanted to get that. If I'm not mistaken, it was 8 ounces. But I already have some of this that I haven't finished. And then I got it here, so I didn't want to, you know, overdo it and get more of these. These I did see online and at the store. Also from Olaplex, I got the Blonde Enhancer Toning Shampoo. This is the purple one. I had never tried this. I didn't even know that they even had a purple shampoo. So I bought this one. This is the 8.5 fluid ounces. I feel like maybe this is the size that you get the shampoo and conditioner with. So I wanted to test this out. The brand Skin Fix, I got the Triple Lipid Peptide Cream. I have heard really wonderful things about this cream. So I wanted to get some creams more like for the evening. So I thought that this was a really good time to try it because it's not a cheap cream, but it has really, really great reviews. And I've heard a lot about it, you know, before, and people raving about it. From Givenchy, I got 2 lip glosses. These are the La Rose Perfecto Liquid Balm. I actually got 2 shades, a more peachy one called Vital Glow number 30 and Free Red number 25, which is not really a red color. It is more of a berry color, and this is definitely more of a peachy type of color. And these just seem to have so much pigment. I was able to swatch them in the store and I absolutely love them. I just thought that they looked really, really pretty. And of course, like, the packaging was just so nice and pretty. So it kind of like sucked me in a little bit. But this is, again, when you want something from higher end brands, this is a really great, great time to take advantage of it. Also, if you want things like the La Mer cream or items that are really, really high end, you also get to take advantage of the discount, because I think it's also hard to even get those products anywhere else at a 20% off, because luxury brands really don't do all that many discounts. I also got some products from Makeup by Mario. I got the Soft Sculpt Shaping Stick, which is this one. I really wanted to try it. I had heard really great things from it. I ended up getting shade light. I was between the shade light and light medium, but the light medium was sold out everywhere. It was sold out online, and it was sold out at the Sephora that I usually go to closest to my house. So I ended up getting the light shade, but I just really love it. I think it's a beautiful shade. I feel like the light medium maybe was a little bit more cool toned than this one, but I think they would have both worked well for me. I also got a blush from Makeup by Mario. This is the Soft Pop Powder Blush, and this is in the shade Mellow Mauve. I just thought that it was a really, really beautiful shade, and I had my eyes on these blushes already for a while, just like I did on the Sculpt Stick. So I don't know, I really liked it. I already kind of tested it out today. It's actually the blush I'm wearing right now. And I really liked it, and I may get some more blushes before the sale is over just to test it out. From Dior Backstage, I got the Face and Body Powder No Powder. This was in the shade 2N. I've also heard really wonderful things about this face powder. Not that I'd be using that much face powder to begin with, but this is what it looks like. It's a pretty big size of a compact. I love the foundation so much. The Face and Body Foundation is so good that they carry at Sephora. And I really wanted to try out the powder. Another gift that I got for my dad, I also got him another cologne, which I totally had forgotten. This is the Mont Blanc Explorer Cologne. I just thought that it smelled so, so good. Cannot go wrong with cologne or like a little money clip wallet he's obsessed with. So he's just very simple, and he just likes the same thing all the time. He'll like those two new colognes because those are some that he has never, never, ever tried. And he's more of a, you know, if you get him the same cologne every year, he will use that cologne every year. I mean, I think he's been using the same colognes for years. Like, he would love Eternity by Calvin Klein. I think he must have used that for over like 35 years and he like loved it. I'm exaggerating. I don't know when Eternity came out, but it's just been for so many years he's been using that same cologne. Other really cool sets that I also got online is this Sparkly Clean makeup set. This one says it's $36 and has a $92 value. And this one has all these cream products that I haven't tried. It has a Merit product that I haven't tried. It has the Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer in the, I have the one that's more like a balm. I had never tried the one that comes in a tube like this. It has, I believe, a highlighter. It also has an Ilia mascara, and then this Tower 28 product. It's supposed to be, there's three full sizes in here, so you really get a really good deal. That's one of the things that I also got online. The Fenty Beauty by Rihanna, the Fly Liner, the Longwear Liquid Eyeliner, they came out with one in brown. I'm really into brown liquid liners. That one is in Brick Truffle, and it just looks like it would be a really, really nice color. Another one that I really recommend that I'm loving is the Roller Lash in the brown. This is also a really, really nice one, and I love it. It's just a very pretty, different, and unique brown. If I feel like I don't like the browns that are almost black, because for that I just wear black. I usually tend to, I like the black eyeliner, but I also love the brown. It just, but I like a true brown, like this color here, the color that you see in the tube. They're like black or a lighter type of brown. And I feel like for wearing during the day or even at night, it just gives you a softer type of look, which sometimes I absolutely love. I mean, don't get me wrong, I also love the black, but I do like the brown a lot, and I wanted to try the Fenty one. They also have another really good shampoo for blonde purple shampoo, like to remove any brassiness, from Amika. I ended up getting that. For skincare, skincare is also a great moment to use this sale for. I really wanted to try the new, this is the Glow Recipe. This is the Guava Vitamin C Dark Spot Treatment. So I bought that one because I feel like, I actually have felt that ever since I got back from my trip to Italy, where I got a little bit of tan, and I'm pretty good at using sunscreen. I use sunscreen a lot. I cover myself, you know, with a hat all the time. But I feel like I did get some more freckles and maybe some darker spots in this area. And I do use a vitamin C, you know, every single morning. But this one has even benefits for removing your dark spots. It says it has 5 forms of vitamin C. It has guava extract and seed oil. And then, of course, the tranexamic acid, which is really good for dark spots. So the fact that they combined it in one, I feel like it is like a no-brainer, and I really wanted to test that one out. Fenty Beauty also had this really nice set that had a cleanser, the toner serum, and their moisturizer. And I also think that these little samples like this, it's also a really good way to test out some new products without you having to commit to the full size, just in case you don't like it. So I also got that one. And also from Fenty, I really wanted to try the exfoliating body scrub, which I had never tried and I had heard really good things of. So I also got that one on. They also had a really great Pat McGrath palette. This is a Mothership Mega Celestial Odyssey palette. Pat McGrath products are amazing. They're really, really pricey. This palette was $78, and it's a really nice palette. I ended up getting it online. They did have it in the store, so I could have gotten in the store, but I wasn't sure if it was going to be available at my Sephora, so I wanted to try that one out. Also, they also sometimes carry items that are a more jumbo size, like you get like a nice big size that is really worth the money. So I ended up getting the Pharmacy Honey Halo Moisturizer in the jumbo size. It was just like a nice little exclusive thing that they had now. The regular size, I believe it's like $45. This one is $68, but it has 3.4 ounces, which is more than double of the original size. And add to that the 20% off. So really wanted to test out this Honey Halo. I ended up getting that online as well. And I also got a little perfume set. These are the Atelier Cologne Mini Perfume Wardrobe Sets. This has 8. It has like 8 little nice size type deluxe samples. It says it's an $85 value, but it was on sale for $55. So I got that. Those perfumes are expensive. I saw some, I smelled them at the store, and they're over $100. The one that I saw, I don't know if it was a bigger size, was like $140 something. So I like the idea that you can actually test them out in a smaller type of size than committing to the full bottle. And then once you use those, if you really, really love it, then of course you can go back and get the full size, and get the full size during a sale is like even better. The brand Supergoop, I also got some sunscreen. This is the Play Everyday Lotion. This one is SPF 50. The reason I got this one as well is because it is actually also water and sweat resistant for 80 minutes. So I did want one where if you sweat or go in the water, it still works. And I just wanted a nice one for my face, so I ended up getting this one. I also wanted to try out the Clinique Even Better Clinical Serum Foundation. This one has SPF 25. Had a hard time matching myself at the store, actually. I should have done the little, you know, sometimes I do the Sephora online type of matching where you select another one of your foundations and they give you a recommendation. It's not always perfect, but it helps you kind of get on track with, you know, around what shade you should be getting. I might have gotten this a little bit too light. I ended up getting shade WN16 Buff. I actually already tested it out and I couldn't make it work. I am wearing it today. I thought the bottle, I think the bottle of this is so cute. I first initially twisted it all off, but it does have a pump. But I first was like, I twisted it off and it came out like this. And I was like, whoa, it doesn't have a pump, but it does have a pump. And it was, I was actually very surprised because by reading this serum foundation, you think it's gonna be something that's a little bit lighter or more liquidy. At least that's what I would associate that with. But it was actually pretty thick. I feel like the first time I tried it, I kind of glopped on a little bit too much and it looked a little bit pale. So you can really use a little bit goes a long way. I just would like dot a little bit on my face and I was able to use that for my entire face. It wasn't even a full pump, I think it's too much for the face. This is actually pretty full coverage. It is not as light as I thought it would be, but it went on really, really nice. I'm kind of just seeing now how it has been wearing throughout the day. I like went out this morning, I had brunch with a friend, and I'm just kind of seeing how it's gonna go throughout the day, but I really wanted to test this out. I've heard really great things about this foundation. So it's different than what I thought it would be, but I don't dislike it. It's just really the first time that I ever tested it out. From Anastasia, I also got the cream bronzer, which I've also heard wonderful things about. It looks like this. I got the shade Amber, and this one, it's a very different tone from the Makeup by Mario one, but I also think that it's gonna be a great one. A lot of people have compared it to, it's kind of like what the Chanel, you know, bronzer used to be, that now they've changed the formula a little bit. The big Soleil Tan de Chanel big bronzer that is so famous, but they did kind of change the formula a little bit, I believe. And I think, you know, a lot of people miss the older formula. They also don't have that many shades, but people are saying that this is something that is like really good and it's very, very, you know, similar to what everybody remembers the Soleil Tan de Chanel cream bronzer being like. And then I also saw they have cream blushes, which I really was excited about. I ended up getting this one, which is Soft Rose. They also had one called, I think it's Peachy Keen, but they didn't have it at the store. So I did go ahead and get it online. I did try the swatch, but I just thought it was a really beautiful, like rosy color. And I'm really excited. I'm actually also wearing it today. Dior, I also got another one of the Dior Backstage Face and Body Foundations, but I ended up getting a color that was a little bit darker than the one that I usually get. I usually use the 1.5N, and this time I got the 2.5N. I'm not one to buy a darker foundation for every single foundation that I own, like when you're more tan or when you're less tan, and some for the summer and for the winter. But I do like having one or two that are a little bit darker that I feel work well with mixing in with other foundations, because then I would just have too many foundations if I had to buy every single color I could potentially need if I'm more pale or if I'm more tan. So in this case, I went with the Dior Backstage in the 2.5. I feel like for the foundations that I use, like this one and the Fenty Eavesdrop, are the foundations that are currently my go-tos. Of course, the La Mer foundation as well, I love. And I feel like this one will mix in well with those, you know? So I think that's what I was gonna do. I almost got the La Mer one because I do have it a little bit darker. See, I have two of them. I have my regular color, which is Linen, and then I also use the Light Ochre color, And I've kind of gone through both of these a lot, and I was almost running out of the light ochre, but I didn't really want to spend the La Mer amount on a foundation that was a little bit too dark for me, and I still have a lot of it left of the linen as well, so I didn't have to restock on the La Mer. And I almost got the Eastdrop, but they didn't have a color that was a little bit darker than mine. They didn't have it in stock, the one that I almost got, so I ended up just getting the Dior. And I think it's just good to have one or two that are a little bit darker than your skin tone that you can mix up with your current foundation if it's too pale for you. I don't think you really need to get every single foundation and every single shade that you may or may not ever need to use. I was really excited to see also that Smashbox kind of took over the Becca. Remember the brightening corrector that was kind of like a pink cream? I'll go ahead and insert a photo of the pink cream below. They had, Becca used to make this really nice like light brightening kind of like corrector. I think it was more of a brightening type of cream that you can use under your concealer. I think the light one is a little bit too light for actually correcting your under eye circles. I like to correct. For me, the ultimate is the Eve Pearl Salmon Concealer. I use a shade medium in that one, and I think that is the best one, but it's a true orangey type of corrector, which is what you need to kind of, you know, get rid of those dark blue purple under eye circles, which I do have. So they have a couple more colors. I was really excited because I did like, the consistency was a little bit different. It was a little bit stickier of that brightening one that Becca had, but now they have it under Smashbox. It's Smashbox for Becca. And I ended up getting the shade medium dark. Even the medium I felt was a little bit too light for what I want true correcting. So I ended up getting the medium dark, and it actually is, you know, a nice orangey peachy type of shade. I really don't think it is too dark for me. I think that a shade like this can definitely work for correcting the under eye area. So I really wanted to test it out because I don't remember, maybe they did, but I don't remember Becca having more than that one light shade. If they did come out with them, I didn't really notice. I only had the light one, and it just worked more as a brightener. I would even have to use a corrector, a concealer, and then that one to brighten. But I tend to always just more prefer having a nice peachy orangey type of corrector. I also restocked on the Brazilian Boom Boom Cream, because this is, I think this is probably like my favorite item from their whole line. They also had a really nice set that you can also get where you do save some money, but it had a lot more products that I don't really use. So for this case, I just went ahead and bought the Boom Boom Cream. But if you do want to try more of their products out, then I would recommend checking out that gift set that they had. I also got some Hourglass. This is the Veil Retouching Fluid. And this is kind of, it's not really a concealer. It's similar to a concealer. I actually got two shades because I didn't know which one would be the shade for me. And it looks like this. And this is basically to retouch. You know how, say you have your makeup on all day and you really want to kind of just do a little bit of touch up. It's that consistency. It's very light and fluid and sheer that you can kind of just put it over your already existing concealer that has already probably been set with a powder, and it's supposed to not get cakey, and it's just supposed to kind of like refresh your concealer. So I was really excited about that. I got the shades Vanilla and Natural. I just thought the idea was very, very cool concept, and it's like that thing that you kind of just want to have in your purse just to touch up your concealer if you have to during the day. So wanted to test it out, and this is the Veil Retouching Fluid by Hourglass. Hourglass also, like they always do, they had their nice little palettes with the ambient lighting powders and blushes. So if you're into Hourglass, those powders, those palettes have a couple products. I think there's like four or five products because they have a long one and four little squares. Those are pricey. Those are also really good to take advantage of during the sale. So for my mom, I also got some YSL lipsticks. These are the Rouge Volup Shine Oil in Stick. And I really like these. My mom loved them. She tried one of mine and she liked them so much that I knew I wanted to get her one. I like these so much because they're, you can venture out to like bright red colors, and they're just so nice and sheer, but they do give you a nice color. So I got her two. I got her this more pinky plum one. This is the Rose Lulu, and this is number 124. I also like how these smell, but these are really nice, luxurious type of lipsticks that it's nice to take advantage during the sale. And I think these are like classic lipsticks that you cannot go wrong with. And then I also got her this red one, Rouge Cape number 83. I wanted to get her a nice red color, and like I said, these are just so good, a red color. It's not too crazy red. It's a nice way to ease into these like more brighter type of colors. I also restocked on my Kosas Air Brow and the Brow Pop Pencil. I use the shade Taupe. These I ended up getting online. I haven't got them yet, but I'm already running out of the pencil. And this is my current go-to, you know, brow products that I like to use. I also got the Dior lip oil online. I don't have it here yet, but I've heard so much about that lip oil, and I tested it out in the store, and it's very sticky. I don't like the very soft lip oils that you feel they're kind of just kind of like melt off your lips. I liked it because it was very sticky. Okay. The berry color, which was like the more darker color that I found, and I always tend to gravitate towards a purpley pink color. So I got berry, excited to test that out. And then I also got, I splurged and I ended up getting the La Mer, the moisturizing soft cream moisturizer. I got the 1 ounce one just to see. I mean, I've never used a soft cream. I've used the regular one and I've used the lotion in the past. So I really wanted to try out the soft cream. So I'm excited that I got online. I also purchased some candles from Nest. The Nest New York candles are amazing. If you want a really nice holiday candle, for me, the best one is the Birchwood Pine. My go-to scent that I love the most is a Moroccan Amber. That is like my favorite scent ever. And I always get the big one, which is actually the ones that I use to put my brushes in, so you could always use it as a brush holder after you use the candle. Moroccan Amber is definitely my favorite, and I also bought some of the Reed diffusers. Those really smell so great in your house. And the Christmas one, the Birchwood Pine, the holiday one, that one also has a Reed diffuser, so I went ahead and got those. So check out the candles online. The Nest brand, I would say, is probably my favorite for the candles and the Reed diffuser. Pharmacy Beauty had the Garden Party Green Clean Trio. I love doing the double cleanse. The Green Clean is my favorite double cleanse. You know, my favorite product to do my first cleanse with, the original one. But they had a nice little set that had three different Green Clean ones. One's like a strawberry, one's a lemon, I believe the other one is a peach. I only saw those online. And Peter Thomas Roth also had, I did not see these in the store, but I got them online, the eye patches, which I really wanted to try another one that actually has like caffeine. I just like lost the page. Full size hydrogel eye patch heroes, 3-piece. And then I have the cucumber one, which I've tried, the green one, but I've never tried the blue one. The Water Drenched Hyaluronic Cloud Hydrogel Eye Patches, Cucumber Detox, and the 24 Karat Gold Pure Luxury Lift and Firm Hydrogel Eye Patches. So those are so pricey, and here you get all three for $75 minus the 20% off. It says it's $182 value. So those are pricey. I feel like if you wanna test those out, it's just better to get the set than just try one out, because I believe one is like $55 if you were just to get one of the one of the eye patches. And Westman Atelier, they have the Baby Cheeks Blush Stick. Really love those blush sticks, those are really nice. Westman Atelier products I really, really like, and I wanted to get some more products of that. You know, I love those blushes. I also have some glosses of theirs that I like. They also have like a contour stick that is really, really nice. So check out that brand, because it's a pricey brand and it's good to take advantage of the sale. And then the last item that I want to share with you guys, that I ended up testing it in the store, but they didn't have my shade, but I was able to use the testers at the store to figure out my correct shade and order my correct shade online. Some of these shades are already selling out. This is a Tower 28 Beauty Sunny Days SPF 30 Tinted Screen Sunscreen Foundation. It looks like this. I ended up getting the color 20 Mulholland, which is light for light and warm undertones. So this is a new product. I've also heard really wonderful things about it, and I feel like this type of foundation, you know, is this is more like a tinted foundation, I guess, like a tinted moisturizer, I think. And I really wanted to test it out, but it just felt so nice and light when I tested it out in the store. So that is pretty much everything that I had my eye out. I can probably like sit here and tell you more amazing things that you can find on the Sephora website. You really kind of have to just search for different things that you want. I have had a wish list already, adding so many things to my loves, and I would add things to my cart just to be ready for when the sale came around. But the sale is taking place now, so take advantage of it. I'm gonna list everything that I discussed in the description box down below. I should be getting all out my products maybe next week. I don't know if you guys would want me to do another video sharing the products that I got that I wasn't able to share with you guys here today. Let me know in the comments down below if you want me to do kind of like a haul video of the items that I was not able to share with you guys today, because I can also do that as well, but I don't know if it'd be too repetitive. And since I already told you about them, if you know, maybe you guys don't want to see them. Definitely take advantage of the sale. Get some of your gifts that you have to get for the holiday season. I just think it's like really, really great. And I'm really excited that I was able to go to the store on the first day and be able to already share with you guys some items that I bought, because usually I feel like I get so many things online and then I wait for those things to arrive and then I film the video that by the time I post my haul, the sale has already, you know, finished. So I really wanted to try to get this one sooner than I usually do, and hopefully you guys have a lot of time to do some nice little shopping at Sephora. So that is pretty much it. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel before you go. As always, I just want to say thank you so much for watching Be Lounge Makeup, and I'll talk to you very, very soon. Bye.